Hey everyone, so today we are going to see the solution of this problem. This was asked in a KVPY exam which was held in the year 2020, and to solve this kind of problem, well, it seems dangerous, but trust me, it's not at all a difficult problem. For this problem we are going to use a very nice trick, or I will say a very nice theorem. So see, whenever you have a definite integral, that means whenever the limits are given to you, and whenever you see a trigonometry term in the picture, you always use a principle which is called as a reflection principle. So reflection principle will always help you to solve the problem whenever you have a definite integral and the trigonometry term. 99% it will help you. So what is reflection principle? If you have integration a to b f of x dx, then it says that this integral and integral a to b f of, you add lower limit plus upper limit minus x dx. Reflection principle says both the quantities are always equal. Okay, so for a continuous function you always have this scenario. Now let's try to apply the same principle over here as well. So now what is our question? Our question is I. Let me call that I. It's always a good habit to give the integral a name. So let your integral be I. So we have this thing, sine square of x upon 1 plus e raised to x dx. Now this integral is same as integral minus pi by 2 to pi by 2 sine square of, here you apply reflection principle, so lower limit plus upper limit minus x divided by 1 plus e raised to lower limit plus upper limit minus x dx. And now if you observe, minus pi by 2 plus pi by 2 goes away, and here also minus pi by 2 and plus pi by 2 goes away. So what you have sine square of minus x. So your I is nothing but integration of minus pi by 2 to plus pi by 2, you have sine square of minus x divided by 1 plus, what about e raised to x? So here also minus pi by 2 and plus pi by 2 goes away, you only have e raised to minus x dx. But now what is sine square of minus x? So since it's a square, so sine square of minus x is nothing but sine square of x. And here you have 1 plus e raised to minus x dx. So this is our I. Let me call this as equation 2. And the one which we assumed our I equal to, let me call this as equation 1. And here what is the reason? Your reason is we have applied reflection principle. That's what the reason here is. Okay. Now we add 1 and 2. When I add equation 1 and 2, on the left hand side I have only I, so I plus I is 2i. Then here you have integration minus pi by 2 to plus pi by 2. Here you have sine square of x upon 1 plus e raised to x dx plus the term which was in the second equation, which is minus pi by 2 to plus pi by 2 sine square of x upon 1 plus e raised to minus x dx. Okay, now you know that integration satisfies a very nice property, that you have integration f plus integration of g, and that is nothing but integration f plus g, right? This is true for definite integral as well as it is true for the indefinite integral. The only thing is the limit should be same. So here if I apply this property over here, I can take out integration outside. So what do we get? We get 2i equal to integration minus pi by 2 to plus pi by 2 sine square x, which is common. Okay, let me write one more step, doesn't make a difference, plus sine square x upon 1 plus e raised to minus x dx by using the addition property. Now here also you can observe, you can take out sine square x common outside. So once you take out sine square x common, what is left? 1 upon 1 plus e raised to x plus 1 upon 1 plus, what is e raised to minus x? It is 1 upon e raised to x. And now if I do the cross multiplication, e raised to x will go here, and this common e raised to x will go in the numerator. So what do we get? We get 2i equal to integration minus pi by 2 to plus pi by 2 sine square of x. You have 1 upon 1 plus e raised to x plus e raised to x upon 1 plus e raised to x, right? Now, since the denominator is same, you can add the numerators. So when you add the numerator, what do you get? You get, so let me write down the first term over here. What is the numerator? Is 1 plus e raised to x. And what is the denominator? It is the same thing, 1 plus e raised to x dx. And this can cancel. So what you are left with? Integration minus pi by 2 to pi by 2 sine square of dx. Now you know how to solve sine square of x dx. You need to use double angle formula. So what is sine square of x? It is nothing but 1 minus cos 2x by 2, right? So therefore, if I apply this formula of double angle formula, I get integration minus pi by 2 to pi by 2. I have 1 minus cos 2x by 2 dx. And now this is a very simple integration, right? You take out 1 by 2 outside. Integration of 1 is x and integration of cos is sine 2x upon 2. And here you have minus pi by 2 to plus pi by 2. So for this, you have 2y equals 1 by 2. Then you open the bracket. So here when you apply to x, so pi by 2 plus pi by 2, so you have pi, and when you put it to sine, so sine of 2x, so 2 into pi by 2 becomes what? 0. And same thing for minus pi by 2, 2 into minus pi by 2. So since we know that sine pi is 0, so this term goes away, right? So you only have, so 2i is equal to pi by 2, and therefore your answer is nothing but pi by 4. So always keep this trick in your mind. Whenever you have a definite integral and a trigonometric function, then you always apply the reflection principle and you will always get your answer. So I hope you understood this problem. If there are any other problems which you want me to solve, you can post them in the comment section. Thank you.